वेलकम टू ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ साइंस पार्क सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी. टुडेज लेसन इज फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 6. इट इज ऑन चैप्टर 7, न्यूट्रिशन एंड डाइट. टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट न्यूट्रिशन एंड डाइट. एज यू नो, डाइट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एज इट डिसाइड्स ग्रोथ ऑफ अवर बॉडी, अवर हेल्थ, अवर इम्यूनिटी, एवरीथिंग. But here I can see something different. The title is Neil's Dinner and there is a plate with dal rice. What is that? Yes, this is Neil's dinner plate. He eats dal and rice only and no vegetables. He is Neil. He is quite choosy about his foods and eats only dal and rice. He is Neil's uncle. He is a doctor. Doctor uncle comes to Neil's place for dinner. He looks at Neil's plate with dal and rice only. Let us listen what they are talking.
Dear Neil, is this your dinner? Looks interesting. But I don't see any vegetables there. Don't you eat vegetables?
I don't like vegetables, but I have dal, rice, chapatis, and sweets. I think that's enough for me.
Well, well, well. Do you know that your body needs 6 types of foods? For what? For proper growth and fitness.
6 types. And which ones are they?
Our staple food mainly contains rice and chapati, which you see here. These contain mainly carbohydrates. Carbohydrates provide us energy. Body needs proteins. For vegetarians, proteins are provided by dals. Moong dal, tur dal, chickpeas, rajma, chole, and such other lentils. For non-vegetarians, it's eggs, meat, fish. They provide proteins. Why do we need proteins? Proteins are needed for growth of our body, strengthening of our muscles, and of course to take care of wear and tear of our body. Wow! I see butter, I see ghee, and of course oil. We all like pakodas. Who doesn't? So fats are also needed, but in proper proportion. Fats are needed for absorption of vitamin A, D, E, and K, as these vitamins are fat soluble. We see iron, calcium, iodine, potassium, sodium, and phosphorus displayed here. Do we need these? Yes, indeed. We do need all these elements or minerals, but in proper proportion again. Let's see what happens if we do not get enough calcium. Do you know that nails, teeth, and of course all our bones mainly contain calcium, isn't it? So what will happen if we develop calcium deficiency? It can lead to brittle bones, or what is known as osteoporosis. Normally, in old age, you will hear about osteoporosis. It can also lead to brittle nails, joint pain, and even hypertension. So, what should we do to get good amount of calcium? Well, eat calcium-rich food. You see a picture. Lot of these you may even like, such as milk, eggs, paneer, cheese, fish, broccoli, and you see a lot of things there. The fifth component of our food, which is very critical to the body, consists of vitamins. Vitamins are of six types: A, B, C, D, E, and K, out of which B is a complex consisting of 8 components or 8 vitamins. Our intake of all these in proper proportion is very vital. The sixth component of our food is fiber. Fiber, we can have fiber by eating fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. This is also needed by the body. In nutshell, let me tell you what our diet should consist of. All six components: carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals, vitamins, and fiber.
But uncle, if I eat only few of them, what will happen?
Neil, look here. Your body and muscles will not grow. You may get sick many times.
Oh my God, I didn't know this. Then what should I eat, uncle?
Neil, obviously you should eat all six things, and that too in proper proportion. I will give you a diet pyramid. Just follow it, okay?
Yes, I will definitely follow it.
This is the pyramid. What you should eat a lot is at the bottom, and what you should eat the least is at the top. So mostly at the bottom, you will eat grains and cereals, carbohydrates. The next, of course, you should eat fruits and vegetables, which will give you vitamins and fiber. Next comes, which you should eat in moderation only: meat, poultry, fish, eggs, dry beans, other dairy products, dals, that is lentils of all kinds. And the least, but you must eat, fat, oil, salts, and sweets. Although you like these things the most, eat them in moderation. Okay?
But uncle, why do we need vitamins?
An interesting question and very important. Look, I will tell you about vitamin A first. For your healthy skin, eyes, bones, and teeth, you need vitamin A. If you eat carrots, papaya, mango, milk, you will get vitamin A. Otherwise, you will have even night blindness and very dry skin.
Oh, really? I love mangoes. Wow.
Now, after we have learned so many things about diet and nutrition from Dr. Uncle, now let us play a game. It's a game of flashcards. How to play it? There are six vitamins in the next slide, and there are food sources of these vitamins given in the next slide. You have to just match this vitamin and the appropriate food source. For this, you can take help from the table given in your textbook. So come on, let us start. Here is vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K, B, and vitamin C and fiber, the last component. Here are food sources for vitamin B, C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K and fiber. You have to match the respective vitamins and the food sources. After this, now you have to find out something. Write down what you had for your breakfast, lunch and dinner yesterday. Now you have to find out the nutrients present in each food item, for which you can take help of Google, and you have to make a table which is given here. One example is shown here. Accordingly, you have to find out for different food items the respective nutrients. As usual, here is some homework. You have to just write down the answers of these questions in your notebook.